Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS on YouTube. Photography is a great part of this hobby, so to learn more about it, I asked some of my friends who make rail painting into an art form. Meet Hunter and Josh.
That was the first time we rode Amtrak together. We were like 5-6 years old, we didn't realize it, and then we figured out, we were talking to our parents about it. Huh. And after that, we met at Connellsville.
That's when our friendship kind of started going up as we realized it.
Despite their young age, they're part of a group of really talented photographers in the Pittsburgh area.
I'm 17.
16.
And how's that been, like, whenever you show your pictures and people are expecting this to be pictures from older photographers and they find out you guys are so young, and you get, what type of reactions have you gotten?
They're just surprised.
With Hunter being the youngest of the group, I asked him for some tips and advice for the younger photographers out there.
I remember that.
So what are you shooting with now?
Canon 7D.
What makes a good train photo?
Just light, sunlight.
Is there like certain times of day that's better to shoot than others?
I like morning, like early morning. When the sun's just coming up, you have the perfect if you're aiming the right way, you have the perfect sun on the nose of the engine. Or evening light.
Do you ever bring any portable lights, or it's not necessary?
Not necessary, unless I'm doing like night stuff.
And it's, a lot of your pictures, you get angles that nobody else gets. How do you think you manage to get that special shot? What makes a great shot?
I just don't want to go like for just a typical photo of just a train. I like to add stuff into it.
What's some of your favorite stuff to add into a photo?
Trees, hillsides, old cars, stuff like that. Anything older to make it stand out.
Have you ever got chased after trespassing or anything?
Oh, yes.
So what would you tell people about, like, how far should you stay away from the tracks? Or
Good 15, 20 feet, yeah. Just away from the rocks.
How do you get a heads up on, like, if there's good trains coming?
Other people around the area. I've got phone calls from a couple buddies or something. They'll let me know in advance, and I'll let them know back on stuff.
Okay. If a young kid was just now getting into taking pictures of trains, what advice would you give him?
Just tell him stay safe, take pictures, add some stuff to them, try to meet new people. I'm taking them, be nice to other people, and tell them, just basically ask them for information and see what they can do.
Tell me about, like, some of the toughest places you've ever had to go to get a shot.
Toughest places? Mance Curve, a lot of people go there. I'm from Sand Patch. Just last Saturday, I was up in Cleveland, went to the, what the building it's called, to the top of the building. You could overlook the whole city of Cleveland, shoot up there. We shot trains from there.
Tallest building in Cleveland, right? It's the Flatiron Building or something.
Something like that. Then just other places, like the back Horseshoe Curve, you can climb up that. It's tough to get up that, I can tell you that, because it's all loose dirt, and you're sliding back down.
So where do you want to head now?
Rad.
Radabar, yeah. Sounds good.
And what's good about this location?
You have the old Pensy signal still up there on one end, and then you have the new Conrail style on the other end, but you have an old abandoned glass plant on the old on the left side of the track, so when you shoot it, you can get the old signals and the train passing the glass plant.
Well, we got some great photos and video that day, and I learned a lot from them. So I encourage you to get out there, get creative with your shots, but please be safe and make some new friends in the railfan community. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my channel under DJ's Trains. Check out my website, djstrains.com. And if you have any questions, ideas, or suggestions, please email me at djstrains@yahoo.com. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a great summer. Bye-bye.